Another question on the forum related to the use of Lexer states. A Lexer state, like I'm in a comment or I'm not, is actually more of a convenience function for allowing us to have different rules depending on where we are. In normal code for HTML or JavaScript, we want to recognize things like angle brackets because they might be part of tags or they might be the less than or greater than sign in a JavaScript mathematical computation. But inside a comment, they don't mean anything special at all. We want to just skip over them because that's some documentation the programmer wrote down for later maintenance. So we used exclusive states, like I'm in a comment or I'm not, to have different rules depending on where we are. A totally legitimate question is, boy, are we going to use these exclusive states to have one Lexer for HTML and another for JavaScript when we write our final web browser? This is a great question. It's going to turn out that we're not going to use explicit states, but we are going to use exactly the same concept. If you think about it under the hood, Lexer states are really just a cute way of giving you two different finite state machines, two different sets of regular expressions, one for in comments and one for not, for example. We will do the same thing just by writing two different sets of token definition files. Here's one for HTML, and here's another one for JavaScript. We'll start with the entire web page that we download from a web server somewhere, and we will feed that to our HTML Lexer and parser. Some parts of the web page will be embedded JavaScript, and we'll see this in great detail in later units. We will gather up those strings and keep them safe, and when it comes time to interpret them, we will pass them to another Lexer, this time a JavaScript Lexer, that will interpret that substring as JavaScript. And this is one of the great joys, really, of computer science. Turtles all the way down or nested Russian dolls. Once you've learned a particular concept, like how to make a Lexer, you can often nest it or have multiple of them at the same time. Once we know how to make a Lexer for HTML, nothing stops us from making an Lexer for JavaScript and having them both running as part of the same program. And that's what we'll do. So officially, we won't be using exclusive Lexer states, but we will end up with multiple different finite state machines used for lexing under the hood.